guys, welcome to Clockwork Night. Pepper's Adventure. Yeah, I'm never going to pronounce his full name. You know how I am with pronunciations. Hey, good lord, look at those eyes just piercing into our soul here. Alrighty, so we can do a little eyebrow dance. We can check out the options real quick. We're going to be playing through the game on normal difficulty. And I'm actually going to boost my players up just a few lives. And, yeah, pretty basic controls here. This game is a, like, 2D, 3D action platformer. Very, very entertaining. Great music, great graphics. Pretty much everything I say about every game I play pertains to this one. So, we're going to start off in Betty's room. You got to go save the princess or the lady, the clock lady. I don't know what her name is. Alrighty. So, this is the gist of the game here. You can see Pepper there. He's our main guy. He's got a keyblade. You can run around, stab things. You can tap the button. You kind of do like a twirling attack. You can see our health on the bottom left. We have three cogs, signifying we have three hits. Our time for the level on the top left, and then you have lives, and on the top right is our point total. You can pick enemies up as well and throw them, stuff like that. Mainly you're just going to be stabbing guys. And yeah, the levels are like super detailed too. You can always keep an eye out for, like, they'll spell words and stuff with all these letter blocks. And it's pretty neat. And there's like, the characters are all referenced in the background, like all over the place. It's crazy. Okay. So, we're going to want to go up here to the left first. Whoa, don't fall off. There's no fall damage, but I just, whoa, don't want to have to do that again. Oh, I need to get used to the controls. It's been a while. Alrighty. So I think we can get a pretty neat bonus in here. Yeah, we can get some coins. Coins are going to be used at the end of each level. There is a minigame where you can gamble your coins for extra lives. If you have 20 coins, you can also use a continue if you run out of lives. So, it's either like you can just gamble it, or you can save it and, you know, for continues. So yeah, it's pretty neat. I don't think there's really any reason to come back this way, so we're just gonna, whoa, head on over to the next area. Okay. Now, there's like tons of secrets like that littered all over the place. I definitely don't know them. In fact, I'm really kind of only familiar with the first two levels, truth be told. I mean, I've beaten the game, but that was like when I was a child. So, I'm pretty pumped to play through this again, needless to say. Alrighty, let's carefully jump our way up here, get more coinage. More coinage is always appreciated, I assure you. Oh, and you can tap the L and R buttons to like get rid of the HUD. Actually see a little bit more on top. Pretty neat, I guess. Yes, Sega Saturn had L and R buttons. And come on, people. Okay, we're at the goal. Now, the goals are kind of weird in this game. Basically, a letter's missing from the stage goal thing here up top, and you need to jump on said letter there on the right. The letters cycle through the word clockwork, so you can kind of time it out if you'd like. However, it's very difficult for me, so we're just going to kind of wing it. And yes! Basically, I just focus on, usually I find that one to be like the easiest. I just focus on that one and count out the letters. Count out the letters. Alrighty, moving on. Each level has two stages in them, and then a boss stage. So yeah, we're already like almost halfway done here, man. Or we are halfway done. The boss is nothing to talk, you know, we'll talk about when we get to him. Okay, whoa, almost got hit by that guy. It's a little weird. And you can also find like switches and shit like this. And eventually, throw some, motherfucker, you can throw shit into it. I need to, oh, that was a lame hit. Did that football respawn? Oh, boo. Well, I could have got some coinage here. You still get one. Oh, and the enemy respawned. Okay. Hit the... Alright, this is the last try. Jesus Christ. And there he is. Okay. For the love of fucking cake. Oh my god! Ah! I'm gonna cheese it! I bet you I can just run off of here. Yes. Good lord. That was embarrassing. We're gonna need more precision if we're gonna actually consider playing this game. Alrighty, that blue thing was a 1-up. If you take the lower path here, and get yourself that sweet, sweet 1-upage. Oh man. Alrighty, get some more time for our efforts here. Look, what am I looking for? You want me to look at your weird doll's cleavage there on the wall? Alright. Fair enough. Press the R button, okay, yeah. Just disappears the HUD. Alright. And down we go! Oops. Can't hold down when you're one of those, apparently. Find yourself a cool little secret here. Yeah, you can also push and pull blocks as well. Alright. Doing good on the coin front. Not ashamed to say that. You also get lives from freaking points, I think, too. Sorry I didn't have time to explain that one. Basically, that was like a golden winder. I don't know what you call those things. The thing that's on my back. Basically, that extended our health total, and it'll stay extended as long as we don't die. As you can see now, we have 4 hits, so... Just don't die, we'll have a huge advantage on boss fights and the like. Alright, get another invincibility. This awesome freaking music, man, seriously. Okay, you can clear that out. That's a bronze winder, and that restores 1 tick of health. The silver ones restore 2. And the gold ones are the life extensions. I'm not sure if there are any other colors. We'll find out, won't we? And you can kind of push blocks in front of books. Ooh. Like, block them off from smacking you. And yeah, you can see, like, all these faces on the books and stuff. There's a lot of Sega references and stuff like that. It's funny, to say the least. Alright, whoa, almost got me there, cool blocks. Okay, and we're already at the goal. Sweet. Man, can I go for a 2-for? I don't know. Let's count it out. Oh man, I can't touch this little part though. I may have got too close. If I touch that, the bonus just immediately ends. Oh, almost. Ah. Okay. Moving onwards to the level boss. Yeah, level boss. I always get stage and level confused, like, all the time. It's annoying. Alright, this guy freaks me the hell out, but he also makes me laugh, so I like him. Alright, just run up and start rustling his jimmies there while he's on the ground. He's gonna bounce around in his little hat and try to smash you. Pretty simple dodge. Oop! Alrighty. And then just rinse, repeat. Just drill him while he's on the ground. You wanna get those buttons off. What? That's my favorite part of the fight. Oh, I even took a hit because I was laughing. You get 4 of his buttons off, he goes into WHAT mode, and his head flies off. And that explodes. Give him some of this, give him a little of that, and there we go, we're done. Woo! What? Okay, anyways. Get a little cinematic here. Now we get to play some roulette. Alrighty. With the cleavage lady. Sweet. Pepper, I'm pleased to see you. How many coins will you wager? Alright, basically, the higher amount we wager, the better chance to find items we'll have. Of course, you know, you're gambling, so you can lose them all as well. We're gonna go ahead and bet 15. Try this out. Keep your eye on the boxes. There's gonna be a red helmet. You see that on the left. And there's also some blue ones. The red ones give you a 3-up, so we're definitely going to be going for that. And I think right here? Oh, a coin. Well, we have to double our luck. I mean, I don't want to lose 15 bucks, man. So, do you see we also have, like, times 2s? Alright, so locked on to the times 2 here. Alright, got it. Feel free to play along at home, see how you do. Because it does show all of them when you get it. Sweet. Alright, yeah, we're gonna need a lot of dosh to make up for me screwing up there at the beginning and getting the coin. Okay. Oh, crap! I totally lost this one. Alright. Alrighty, we lost everything, guys. Moving on, we're just gonna farewell. Speaking of farewell, thank you guys for joining me for the first episode. I'll see you next time. We'll take on the next level. Just kidding. Alright, have a good one, guys. Have a safe journey. Come back soon.